In this video, you will learn how to build, execute, and debug loops in KNIME Analytics Platform. Ready? Let's go! Let's have a look at the example workflow. Here, we want to use a loop to create a timestamp of the 15th day for each month in 2023. We create a table with two columns, day and year, each having one value, 15 and 2023. Next, we want to repeat creating a timestamp 12 times and concatenate the results. For that, we add a counting loop start node to the workflow. Some loop start nodes have dynamic ports, meaning you can add different types and numbers of ports. If you use the quick node adding panel, the correct port will be added automatically. We set the number of iterations to 12. Each loop start node produces the flow variable current iteration with the counter of the current iteration. Counting in KNIME Analytics platform starts from 0, so the first iteration number is 0. In the loop body, we then use a math formula node to add 1 to the current iteration number and produce the month's value. And we use a string manipulation node to create a timestamp. Finally, we add a loop end node. In the configuration of this node, you can decide how to treat duplicate row IDs from different iterations, add an iteration column if you want to indicate which rows are generated in which iteration, export variables modified in the loop body back to the main workflow. By default, the modified values won't be propagated. And finally, enable or disable varying inputs from the different iterations. This allows us to handle generation of empty tables and deal with data where mismatches in column types can occur. The most straightforward way to execute the whole loop is by executing the loop end node. While the loop is executing, you can see the progress loop sign at the loop end node. At the node monitor, you can see the progress of the loop execution in the changing flow variable current iteration and the maximum number of iterations. Now the loop has been executed. The resulting table has 12 rows with the respective timestamp and the iteration number in which each row was created. If you want to reset the whole loop, you can reset any node in the loop body as well as the loop start and the loop end node. Before starting the whole loop, you might want to test that it executes as expected on a couple of iterations. Besides, sometimes a loop can fail and you might need to debug a particular iteration. This is where the stepwise execution comes in handy. For that, in the loop end node action bar, click the step button. This will execute one iteration of the loop and pause. You can see in the node monitor that the current iteration is now at iteration 0. If you now click the step button again, the loop will go to iteration 1 and so on. To run all the remaining steps, you can click the button Resume. To pause the loop during execution, click on the Pause button. Note that the nodes in the loop body will be fully executed for this iteration, but starting the next iteration will be paused. You can also choose to cancel the loop execution. Another way to debug a loop is by using a breakpoint node. It can be inserted in any place in the loop body and, when enabled, holds execution when the incoming data fulfills a specified condition. A breakpoint can activate, for example, when a variable matches a particular value. For instance, we want to stop the loop when it reaches June, meaning at iteration number 5. Let's execute the loop. As you can see, at the 5th iteration, the breakpoint failed, the loop stopped, and we can inspect the results. Once we are ready, we can disable the breakpoint and execute the loop completely. In this video, you have learned how to build, execute, and debug loops.